NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world.
Bird Gang, what's going on, guys? We're back at it again. M Devil NFL podcast. Type. We got the game of the week here. Kansas City Chiefs versus the Pittsburgh Steelers. I'm thinking that's a pretty good matchup. Both 2-1. Not the best possible matchup, but we do have the breast cancer awareness going on the field, on the players, on the coaches, all the pink everywhere. All pink everywhere. So, pretty lit. Because, you know, but let's get into last week's scores, what happened. We'll talk about it a little bit. What was really impressive, what was just whatever. Patriots 27-0 over Titans on Thursday Night Football. Super impressive. They smashed them hoes. Brock Osweiler looked terrible. Patriots just win with whatever. They're just too good. And they're straight savages. Patriots killing the game. Let's go to the rest of the games here. We got the Raiders beat the Titans on a last second. Not a last second, but there was a last second opportunity for the Titans that they couldn't deliver on. Unfortunately. I'm actually currently... Oh, my God. I'm recording this on Saturday while I'm watching college football. I'm actually watching a YouTube game. Not working out too great for your boy. I was supposed to be at the game. Didn't really work out. Travel plans, but yeah, kind of sad. Kind of sad happenings right now here in Devil. In the Devil game Raiders beat the Titans. Browns and Dolphins went to overtime. The Dolphins ended up coming through for the squad. Why are they running the read option without Smith getting sacked or tackled for a big loss, whatever, same thing. And now it's fourth down. Well, there they went blitz defensively, Charles, and things were paved well coming from the linebacker position. Dolphins came through with the win. This is like two of the worst teams in the NFL going against each other, and it lived up to all the hype. Overtime. We got Ravens staying undefeated against the winless Jags with a game-winning field goal by Justin Tucker. Lit. Ravens 3-0, Jags 0-3. Crazy. If anything, I would have flipped those two, even though I wouldn't have expected the Ravens to not win a game. But the Jags, I thought, were kind of turning the corner a little bit, but so far this year they haven't really. Lions versus Packers. Packers came through. They started with a huge lead and almost blew it at the end because Lions were fighting back. What's his face? Balled out of control, Marvin Jones. Broncos versus Bengals. Broncos are just straight savages. Everyone knows that. Vikings versus Panthers. This is probably the biggest surprise of the week. The Panthers are 1-2, just like the Cardinals are, and the Panthers did win that game, so Cardinals still have hope for playoffs. Redskins also beating the Giants, which also a big upset today. Rams beat the Buccaneers. That's not too unexpected, honestly. There was a 1 hour rain delay in that game, maybe even more than an hour. 49ers, look at those pink shoes, those are kind of dope. 49ers lost to the Seahawks, and Russell Wilson did get injured and sat out the entire fourth quarter and part of the third, I believe. And apparently he's going to not miss any games, but he's definitely not going to be 100%. So that bodes well for the Bird Gang, trying to get that West banner back to back. Touchdown Steelers already. They're straight savages, these guys. We got Jets and Chiefs. Jets just got their face smashed in. Nothing. Six picks from, what's his face? Fitzpatrick. They call him Six Patrick. Or Six Picks. Picks. I don't know. Something where he throws a lot of picks. He threw six picks. That's kind of crazy. Dude threw six picks in one game. Carson threw a lot of picks too, though. So, Chargers versus Colts. Colts came through with a win late. And this was the biggest shocker. Eagles destroyed the Steelers. The Steelers, who I thought were among the best teams in the NFL, top three teams in the NFL, in my opinion, got straight wrecked by the Eagles. and the Eagles might actually be a legit good team. So, who knows that. With their rookie quarterback. You never know. This could just be like a flash. Flash in the pan. Bears got beat by Cowboys. Everyone knows that. Bears are straight trash. And then Falcons beat the Saints on the road, which is surprising me. Saints are basically eliminated from the playoffs. Most likely. That's the weekend wrap-up. Oh, Cardinals lost the Bills, sadly. Could have won that game. Carson threw for four picks. I think they were all in the fourth quarter, too. And just didn't come through. J.D. McCoy had two break-off runs, kind of really sucked. But, yeah, kind of sad. Cardinals lost 1-2. Not what I was expecting to start the season. Not at all. But you look around the NFC, no one's really, like, this ultimate team. There's no, like, the Vikings look like the best team, honestly, in the NFC. So, that'll come into play with our power rankings later. So, okay, let's start with week four. We're going to get into it. We're going to go over the first game already, the Thursday night color rush game, Dolphins versus Bengals. Bengals kind of dominated this entire game. AJ Green is a straight savage. Everyone already knows that. 173, one touchdown. AJ Green straight killing the game, destroying everyone. Anyone that moves, he just destroys them because he's a beast. Good stop there. For the Steelers. Okay, let's start off with the very first game of the day, which is the super, super early game. The Colts versus Jaguars. That game starts at like 6 a.m. my time, I think, or 7 a.m. my time, something crazy like that. Colts versus Jaguars. It is in London, which is pretty lit, if you ask me. That'd be a really dope game to go to. If I was in London, I would definitely go. There's a flag on the play. I don't even think that there is even. Yeah, you can't even buy tickets on StubHub for it. That's weird. Maybe StubHub only operates in the United States, which that would seem weird, but maybe. Holding. Bring them back. They're going to probably just decline it anyway. Andy Reid is heated with that pink shirt on. That's a little bit much. An all-pink shirt? That can't be what the coaches are wearing. It just can't be. These fools never wear all pink. They usually have, like, pink in the logo or, like, a ribbon built in or, like, gray with pink hints. As he'll kick it away for the second time. Straight pink is a little much. I'm not sure a girl's basketball team. 45 yards. This looks good as well. Oh. With it is Brown. AB. Decent little return. Next game, we got the Titans versus the Texans. Texans are 2-1. Going into last week, I thought the Texans were a good team. They were 2-0, and then they got straight destroyed by the Patriots on Thursday night. Texans are the favorites, and I want to go with the Titans, honestly. I want to rock with my homie Marcus. Shout out to the O, Oregon Ducks. Marcus Mario to come through with the squad. I didn't even pick the Colts versus the Jags. I'm going to go with the Colts. Jags are trash. I had faith in the Jags going into the season. They're straight trash now. We got Browns versus Redskins. I'm going to go with the Redskins because I'm going to go with the Redskins because everyone knows the Browns are the worst team. And this one complete to Marcus Wheaton. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
Gonna go with the Redskins because we know Browns are the worst team in the NFL. Yeah, everyone knows that. We got Seahawks versus Jets in New Jersey / New York. I'm actually going with the Jets on this one. We don't know how healthy Russell Wilson is. We don't know what's going on with him. The Jets are a better team than 1-2, truthfully, and I think that they can come through and actually get a dub here. The Jets need to if they're going to start to push for that playoff berth, that wild card berth. Definitely not pushing for the division, fam. We already know that. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Well, usually you don't think of the cornerback coming in for a no-gain play, but that's what we had there. Nice tackle.
Okay, let's go with the next one here. Bills versus Patriots. I'm going to go with the Bills coming through. The freaking Patriots can't go 4-0 without Tom Brady. They can't do it. Is that serious? Is that real life? These fools cannot do that. It's not fair. It's not fair to everyone. I don't like it.
They've got it second and 10 to start things out.
Stupid. I'm watching this ASU game and it's really, really sad right now. It's really hurting my feelings. Bills versus Patriots. We're going with Rex, Sexy Rexy. Next, we got the Panthers.
On second down, Roethlisberger. His throw incomplete. Marcus Wheaton was the one he was looking for. And it'll be third and 10.
We got Panthers versus Falcons. This is ESPN's official game of the week for. So ESPN.com, they rate all the like strength of all the matchups, and they're ranking this as the best matchup between teams. Not necessarily like biggest impact, but like most fairly matched teams, and should be the best game. Let's see if Ben Roethlisberger can do it. I picked these two teams just because they're both 2-1. They both made the playoffs last year. The Falcons are 2-1, but the Panthers are 1-2. I'm gonna go with the Panthers to get the dub here on the road at the Falcons, but. I don't think it's going to be easy for them. They've been struggling this year. And who knows? Matt Ryan is slinging. Everyone knows that. Matt Ryan is straight slinging. And he's throwing for a lot of yards, throwing for touchdowns, all that good stuff. And he's being a straight savage. You know he already is a straight savage.
Now a first down carry
I'll
by
be
Bell.
Just
and he'll
slanging.
Find his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
I go all the way back to college with Le'Veon Bell.
Sorry, guys. I'm watching this ASU game, and it is heartbreaking for me. These fools from USC are just straight driving.
And 2 years ago,
what else we got here? We got the Ravens versus the Falcons.
I think they
in Baltimore. I'm going with the Ravens to start the season 4-0. Because we bird ganging out here, the birds of a feather flock together, fam. Actually, the Ravens are my second favorite team in the NFL. They have been for a while. Mostly because they used to have Todd Heach, and they still have Terrell Suggs. Those are two Sun Devils, two of the best Sun Devils that were in the NFL at the time, two Pro Bowlers. And they don't have Todd Heap anymore. I don't think he's even in the league anymore. But he definitely isn't in the league anymore. He's old. So he's definitely not in the league anymore. And there we go, touchdown. Give it to him one time. Give it to him, baby. But yeah. Steelers out here. Steelers was my Super Bowl pick, guys. And after they got shellacked by the. They got shellacked by the Eagles in the game of the week last week, which was probably the worst game because the Eagles just straight murdered those fools. They're not looking that great as the Super Bowl pick anymore. But we'll get into that later with them power rankings, fam. Just rankings. They don't even have to be power rankings. But I'm going with the Ravens to start 4-0. We got the Lions versus the Bears. These are two bad teams. I'm going with the Bears to get their first dub of the season. Even though I do think that they're one of the worst teams in the NFL. Hopefully they come through and they get a win. We got the... Broncos versus Buccaneers on the road at the Buccaneers. I'm going to go with the Broncos. They're too good right now. Trevor Siemian's coming around and he's starting to ball a little bit. And we'll see what comes out of this young whippersnapper.
This one taken just inside the 10.
Let's go.
Solid return.
And then we got Rams versus Cardinals. Bird Gang AF. I'm gonna be in the building. I'm gonna be screaming my face off. Cards are the 8-point favorite at home. Rams are 2-1. Cards are 1-2. Cards can push for first place, I guess.
They need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
Yeah, Rams versus Cards. We got a bird gang on these hoes. Cards got to pull this one out. It's important. The Cardinals, 1-2. They need to win this game. Otherwise, it'll be terrible. And we actually last year lost this exact game. It was the fourth game of the season. We were 3-0. It was the first weekend in October. And we wore the black jerseys, which we are doing again. And we lost to the Rams. So everything lines up. Hopefully we just flip. But except on that day, ASU had won the game in LA. They won the game against UCLA at the Rose Bowl, which I was at, and then I drove back overnight, came back home, watched the Cardinals lose to the Rams, which was sad. But it's so it's flipped. ASU's gonna lose, which they already are, which is devastating. But Cardinals gotta come through with this win. It's super important. They need to get some playoff seeding. They need to push for wins. They need to raffle off like 10 in a row. Get up there to 11 and 2. I'll be hyped after 11-2, and then they can get themselves first place again. Get that number one seed. God, I would want them to have that number one seed. We got Saints 0-3 versus the Chargers 1-2 at Qualcomm. Shout out to that parking lot where we'd be light, right in that light rail, fam. Let's go with the Chargers at home on this one. They are the 3.5-point favorites. The Saints look so bad. So, gotta go with the Chargers on this one.
That's fielded in the end zone.
Downed. And no run back. Next, we got the Cowboys versus 49ers in Levi Stadium in Santa Clara. I'm going with the Cowboys to come through with the dub. I feel like the 49ers are straight trash. They have been the whole season. And we're going with the Niners. I mean, not the Niners. Cowboys. Niners are sure trash. Cowboys are good. Not even dope. They're not even that good. Shout out to Dak. Shout out to homie Dak. Let's get. And then we got the Monday night game, Giants versus Vikings. That's actually a super hype game. I should have picked that one. What is that one rated on the ESPN rating? Dang, number 6? That's low, I feel. That's super low on the ESPN like quality ratings. Is that Holden? I feel like this second quarter is taking so long for some reason. Shout out to the Bird Gang one time. Let's see what the Steelers can do here. Holding on the Steelers, fam. Still first down.
They'll come out in the pistol.
Oh, and we got bye weeks this week. Oh, that's a fumble? Yeah, that was pretty much a fumble.
And it took the ball off course. All right, let's take a peek at the league-wide landscape. 5 teams undefeated at 3-0. You've got the Ravens, Eagles, Pats, Vikings, and Broncos. Now, partner, throw out for a second, if you will, the Pats and the Broncos. Of those other 3 undefeated teams, who has the biggest chance of making some noise?
I think the Vikings. And I know
that. Yeah, he did like the current standing. They have to record this thing. Injury,
and that's working out pretty well. He's 2-0 so far as a starter. But it's their defense.
There goes Green.
Do you hear that commentary? They like said all the undefeated teams and like which ones they think are going to be good. And that's crazy.
A big play there on the catch and run. 78 yards.
But yeah, Giants versus Vikings, really hype game. Could possibly be the game of the week, honestly. I decided to go with the AFC one. This NFC game, and I went with Steelers last week, and I've already gone with Vikings already. But I guess when you're among the best teams in the league, you're going to... you're going to be featured on Game of the Week multiple times, like the Cardinals last year. Down the stretch, it was like they got moved to Sunday night like 3 times, which is crazy. But Steelers trying to put it in real quick. Hey, we're all trying to just put it in real quick, right? I like your boy. Screen! That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. Is that Le'Veon? Yeah,
he showed off the athletic juke, but it didn't buy him a whole lot of real estate.
I'm not sure how many people anticipated
Giants versus Vikings. I'm going to go with the Purple People Leaders, the Vikings, to stretch their lead on the NFC. 3-0 right now, going to 4-0. I picked a lot of the undefeated teams to win. I feel like I picked all the undefeated teams to win. The Eagles aren't playing. I might have picked against the Eagles. Giants aren't bad, though, but the Vikings defense is so good. I don't know when they're going to start losing games because it needs to happen, fam. Because the Cardinals, we need to catch up. The first half was taking so long, I feel. It's already been a full 20. And it's not even, we're not even at the end of the first half yet. Let's go, no huddle, guys. Come on, fam.
Yo, what about that mutt freaking catastrophe that EA perpetrated? I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay,
I'm trying to watch this Clemson game. He was looking back and forth. But Clemson is out here doing things. They out here doing things.
On third and goal, Roethlisberger.
They showing
finding time.
Louisville coming back though.
This will be caught just inside the 10. Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs.
Okay, yeah, going with the Vikings, stay undefeated. Then we got our featured match of the week. We got the Chiefs versus Steelers, which is this guy right here, the AFC playoff teams from last year,
so
both 2-1, we're in Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh needs a rebound.
Action.
Chiefs need to make a statement. Both of these things. Pittsburgh is the favorite. I'm going with the Steelers. I still think they're among the league's elite. And, yeah. Okay, let's take a look at... let's take a look at MVP candidates right now. Who is an MVP candidate right now in this league today? I don't even know. Like, Drew Brees and Jameis Winston are throwing for a lot of touchdowns. Aaron Rodgers is as well. These teams aren't looking that great, though. You want a guy that's winning games, that's also slanging Ben Roethlisberger with the 6 touchdowns and the good record. Shout out to the homie Carson Wentz, even though he doesn't have a lot. Trevor Siemian, maybe? Even though he has the 3 picks. He is undefeated. Tom Brady? Nah, can't be Tom Brady, fam. I don't even know. Who's the other undefeated team? It can't be Sam Bradford. No way, Sam Bradford. I think right now it's got to be Ben Roethlisberger. He's the only one that's out here balling. But he has 4 picks. That's way too many. Aaron Rodgers' stat line looks amazing, but they're not looking that great as a team. They've lost already. I don't see them as one of the elite teams right now. Aaron Rodgers always wins a freaking... You know who it's going to be right now? Let's go with the homie Matty Ice. The homie Matty Ice. Let's go with him as our front-running favorite.
They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure... If something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
We'll go with Matty Ice, Matt Ryan. Pretty lit.
On first down, Smith. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it off to Jamal Charles there.
Brandon, while we have a quick second here, can we talk about the Ravens a little bit?
Sure.
Because they're off to a 3-0 start. Remember the rough season they had last year with all the injuries, and they're getting a lot of those guys back and playing at a really high level. Joe Flacco from his knee injury, Steve Smith Sr. from the Achilles, Drill Suggs from an Achilles, and it's all coming together early for Baltimore.
Yeah, they always seem to be in the mix. Big win, although it was in Jacksonville, is now 0-3. Big road win this
come on,
week.
Let's go.
Remember in preseason,
let's go. They're calling timeouts because they want the ball back, Pittsburgh is? Yo, Tomlin is too much of a savage. I'm hoping Tomlin just runs his clock out next half because
so the defense had a chance
this
to
game is dragging,
breath,
I feel like.
Back out and ready.
Like, legit dragging. This video might be an hour. I want to get this whole simulation in, but come on, man. Shout out to NFL Live. I know, I'm a little preoccupied watching college football right now. This is what I do on Saturdays. I either go to a college football game or I watch college football. Oh my god.
They'll run it now. This is Chuck Hendrick West. Calling no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. And the Steelers signal for another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Getting smacked around right now. I'm butthurt about it, guys. You guys are in there. They're down in this Clemson right, game, so though. Shout out to Louisville. Shout out to the Bird Game.
Back out onto the field for the defense.
Can I get out of this freaking... This walking around bullcrap. Do I not have... I don't know why it's doing this. Yo, I don't need to watch... I don't need to see the coach. I don't need to see the dude jumping around. Let's just go. What is going on?
Here's Dustin Colquitt now.
It took that long to get the punt team out there? Come on, man.
And he puts a little something extra into this one by far his best of the night.
Oh, come on, AB. You can't do that.
And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line.
Come on, are you serious right now?
The Chiefs defense getting
really about
ready
to show
to
me
roll.
This full highlight.
And they did well down near the goal
of this punt
time,
that just gets down. This is crazy. I must have set this up wrong or something.
Settling for a field goal of that distance is amazing. You can get 3 points now, or it's going to give you only 1 point for the extra point, which would be a little bit longer. But they have to feel fantastic about only giving up three in that situation. It could have been so much worse.
Yeah, could have. Now can they carry that over? A group of Chiefs there to make the stop that time.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space.
Dude, the Steelers can chuck it.
If
no, they ain't even trying to.
There, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. So we reach half.
Well, thank God I can skip something.
Easy there, LR.
They were not giving me any skip options, and it was killing me. I don't need to see Roethlisberger warming up, fam. I saw dudes warming up earlier. Let's get into the power rankings right now. We'll do our top five, bottom three. Number one team right now, it has to be the New England Patriots. They're just too good. They're undefeated, and they don't have their quarterback, and then they didn't have their second-string quarterback, and they are losing their third-string quarterback, and it's freaking nutso. And they're just smashing fools. They didn't smash the Cardinals. They won on the last second missed field goal by one of the top kickers in the NFL. But other than that, they still won. They still beat the Cardinals, who I still contend are one of the best teams. And ESPN's power rankings have them as the number five team in the NFL still, which is kind of crazy to me. But I guess that's what people think of this Cardinals team. I don't know. I wouldn't rank them that high. I'm not going to have them in the top five.
Here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in
the
second half.
Let's go to the next one. I got Patriots number one. I got Denver Broncos number two. Their defense is just too rabid. Like, they just ravaged. They're savages. And Simeon's coming along. So that's really, really impressive. Third, I gotta go with the Minnesota Vikings. They're undefeated still. They've won two really impressive games, I feel like. And they did lose their running back, but that hasn't really mattered. And they lost their starting quarterback as well, but they got a new one. And number three team, Minnesota Vikings, undefeated. Number four team.
And that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
Let's go with the Philadelphia Eagles, undefeated, 3-0, my number four team in the NFL power rankings. Just rankings. I don't know why I keep saying power. It doesn't even make sense. Number four team, Eagles, undefeated, 3-0. Defense is great. They destroyed one of my other high-rated teams, the Steelers, who I think are very good. And not that far off of still keeping them out of the Super Bowl contender out of the AFC. Come on, man.
It really didn't matter who got the ball in the play, because there was no space to go. So that I think you step back.
But yeah, Philadelphia Eagles, they're freaking beasts. Wentz is coming along. Looks like Simeon. Their packages are super basic, but he's getting the job done. He's winning.
The intended receiver, and that's going to make it fourth down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more.
Yeah, perhaps.
Next, we got number 5 team. I want to go with the Ravens, but I don't think that they're that good. I'm going with the Pittsburgh Steelers. I know they got beat, or they have a loss, and the Ravens don't. And they got beat pretty bad by the Eagles.
Taken from just outside the 30. Slips past him.
But I still think what they did early in the season shows that they're a good team. They beat the Bengals already, and then they beat the brakes off of someone else. I can't even think of it right now. But I'm still going to go with that. I'm going with these Pittsburgh Steelers that are right here on your screen as the fifth best team in the NFL. Don't have the Cardinals in there, and don't have the Ravens. Those are my two favorite teams. I don't have either one. And even though ESPN still has the Cardinals in the top five, which is crazy. But that's based on people's votes, so.
Do people use green? Sports, or you mean magic marker board?
Yeah, those two.
Let's go.
And Hill with it over the middle. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49.
Let's see if we can get a good game rolling out of
it. Recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move
the
sticks.
See if Lamar Jackson can bring his team back all the way. Only down two now. They were getting smacked earlier. They were down like 18 or something like that.
He's got time.
Nope.
Right. He's just going to get rid of this thing.
I feel like they were losing 10 to 28 earlier. They were only down 2 points.
Whether they deserve credit or not, the defense is going to take credit for that incompletion because it always feels good when you slow down an offense.
Look at this. No clock running. No hurry up, no nothing. Lamar Jackson out here running around being savage. I kind of stopped watching the ASU game because it just makes me sad. This Clemson Louisville game is really good right now. Get the holding on him.
And Wilson has it. And he's taken down at the 43. But
I keep flipping back to the ASU game. It's just not getting any better.
Holding offense.
Bottom three in the NFL. These are my rankings. Ooh, we could put the Cardinals down there? No. Not doing that. Third worst team. What do we got? I'm going to go with the... Third worst team, I'm going to go with the Jaguars. I know I've been kind of dick-riding the Jaguars for a while this season. I talk about how they're, like, coming up and they made a good draft and they got young guys that are looking good and all this stuff. They got a decent quarterback. Shout out to the Bortles service. And, yeah, I'm going with them as the third worst team. The second worst team, I'm going with the Chicago Bears. That is pretty obvious that they are straight garbage. Jay Cutler. Jay Cutler is not a good quarterback. He's not that good. And
here's Dustin Colquitt now.
They're a pretty bad
as
team.
The drive goes backwards,
Bears.
So he's on to punt it away.
0-3 Jaguars, 0-3 Bears. Next we're going with the 0-3 Cleveland Browns. They actually almost beat the Dolphins. If I was doing bottom five, Dolphins would probably be in there. But they almost beat the Dolphins. They did go to overtime and they lost it. But Browns the worst team. They're straight trash. They are going to like their third or fourth string quarterback already this season. That's crazy talk. Shout out to RG3 out there getting injured. That's awesome to me. I don't like that dude. He's already made his millions. I know it's not cool to wish someone like injuries so they can't work. They can't do their job. But this dude's already made millions. He doesn't need it.
Brown, the lone receiver left.
That's why I don't feel bad wishing for dudes' injuries in the NFL, especially if they're like
they
veterans
play here
or stars.
Surveying the field. Blitz coming in
Chiefs coming through trying to get them sacked.
The safety blitz turns out to be a great call defensively as they sack him for a loss of 9.
Thought it was strong safety. Some Hassan Abdullah, may not realize it's not.
It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back.
But Brown's straight trash, garbage dudes.
On second down, Roethlisberger finding time.
Ooh, Big Ben. Oh, he almost throws the pick.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude.
He almost throws the pick.
But I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Incomplete pass.
Man.
On second down, let's see what the offense draws up.
Bird gang, guys. And I want the Cardinals to win so bad. They're rocking the black jersey for the first time this season. It's probably the only time. They even only wear them once per year. But I'm hyped. Gonna be there. Gonna be rocking my infrared sixes. I'll let your boy with them. Just because they got that little pink hint to them. Because they his breast cancer awareness month, man. So we gotta hit him with that pink a little.
I think they did
little
exactly
bit of pink,
that
a little
that
bit
play.
Of, it's infrared,
down,
but it's
taking
a little
care
bit
of the
pink.
Ball well.
And being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half.
Just like your steak, just a little bit of pink.
44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. And he'll take it just outside the 40.
You try to hit him with that shimmy.
It's a 40-yard punt, 4 yards
said, nah,
on the
fam.
Return. And possession
21 yards per
hands,
return? That doesn't make
10.
Sense. Is that like...
And now here comes Kansas City.
Did he bust
and
one for like 40
deficit,
yards?
Because
that was just like 1 yard, right?
Like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist.
I'll be just swinging.
Right? So you've got to go
I woke up
out
super early today, guys, because Nike's a bunch of dicks,
no,
and every time they want to do sneaker release, they do it at like 6
fault.
O'clock.
Pacific time.
Or
7 game.
O'clock
he'll get a nice
time,
chunk there on the first down run.
I wake up early, try to get these OBOs.
Shout out
to your boy, Drizzy. You guys already know I rock with Drake.
He was the finisher. A really nice run.
Excited.
See if they stay on the ground for
it's
second
a six
down.
Upside down. It's a 9 now. Is that how many wins that the Chiefs are going to have? 9? They already got 2.
We'll return with more
only
after
need 7
break.
More. That's not even
you're
that
watching
many.
The NFL on EA Sports.
Man, at this point, I'm hoping the Cardinals get at least their win. I guess you could always hope that they just... Oh, my God, I had the chance to skip, and it's just not letting me. What is going on? This is taking so much longer than normal for some reason, guys. I'm so sorry. But the third quarter did go by a little bit faster. Let's see what the... Let's see what the Chiefs can get rolling here. Let's see if they can mount themselves. Ooh,
Charles.
Nice little block there.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Call it a gain of 7 and it gets him a new set of downs.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
So it'll be first down here after the run. First down throw.
Let's go out. Rep the pack. You gotta rep that pack. He's from Utah even before they were in the Pac-12, but he's gotta rep the pack now, boy. Gotta count him. Gotta count him as a pack representative, guys. Shout out to that Pac 11 fan.
It's almost like you said, listen, if you're gonna sell the go, just go. Let's see who's faster.
So the offense has it first and 10. Play fake here on first down.
Ooh.
And it's caught over the middle. Wilson.
They're just driving.
Down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
See him dance around or do something. Oh,
like
just walk a little
tight
bit.
End, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing.
Slot receivers out here making plays.
And they're route running savvy.
It's true.
And
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone.
Oh my gosh, what is this penalty?
The first down carry here for Charles. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Off the corner, where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he was a big factor in the run game, no gain.
Throwing is Smith, and this is caught. Jeremy Maclin.
Maclin trying to put it in, fam.
And that's going
to
make it
gonna run it down to the 2-minute warning, Maclin. You got to get up, boy. Got to hurry. Andale. Hombre. Definitely getting down to the 2-minute warning.
Time for a break.
Dang.
We're back to finish.
USC
this
is so good for some reason. I don't understand. Hit him with that skip, fam. Skip-o. Defense.
So the Chiefs defense. The ball as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Smith on third down.
Touchdown.
And this is caught down for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
And they put it in the
dang.
End zone, which was
Clemson
one.
Just threw a pick, fam.
And then it's decision
Clemson
time.
Just threw a pick.
This is what all teams go through. You look at
the clock. I know, I'm just sitting here watching college football games while we're rocking with the M-Devil NFL podcast.
Yeah, how do you feel about your defense?
And, oh man, this, so I'm just beat, guys. I was up so early trying to get these OVOs. These Drake Jordans, because I rock with the homie Drizzy.
It's getting late.
I had to put this out before Sunday. You guys already know. I'm Devil NFL Podcast. We in here. What are we doing right now? Oop. Lamar Jackson said, I'm about to put the squad on the back, fam. Still not even past the 2-minute warning. Come on, bruh.
Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. On the return, here's Justin Gilbert. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Chiefs defense, they get set and ready to do battle again. They do have all three timeouts remaining, but a first down likely ends this thing.
And it looks
let's
like
see if they can rock this out real quick
phrase,
and end this
the defensive here, right? But in fact, the team on offense has to be really careful because they're going to attack like crazy. They've got to cover the football, make sure they don't turn it over, and still find a way to finish off this game despite the extra pressure that's going to come their way.
Do you pack it in for a run here on first down?
I think that you do. That's how you have to play it. But at the same time, you're telling your ball carrier, both arms over the football, body, everything else, because they will do everything possible to try and knock it free.
They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. And able to break. Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Let's go. Let's freaking go.
And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Yards to go here on second down. Another pistol look here.
Let's go, guys. Let's just run this clock out. Get this dub.
And he'll be tackled
just passed you got 35 at the 36. Okay, let's go. I know you're calling timeout. Let's just go.
But still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now
just 3 yards will probably wrap it up. Wrap it up like Trojan. That works on two levels today, fam. Oh my god, USC is too good right now. Their quarterback got taken out. They're so far ahead. Yo, this is a USC team that lost 3 games already. Come on, man. Come on. I hit the freaking the skip. I hit the skip, and this is how long it takes. This last 2 minutes is taking so much longer than the rest of the game. That first half took a long time. First down. Let's go. Skip, 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 skip. Let's go.
The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play.
Why am I just doing this right now? It's crazy. It's ridiculous. And going on this whole thing. It's nuts. It's nuts. This is still going on right now. Just run this out. Kill these fools. 3-point lead. Finish them off. Why is this taking so long?
They come up with one running back. That's Bell. And they'll give it to him here.
There we go. This will be it. This will run it out, guys. We're wrapping it up. We're going with the Steelers with the dub, just like in the simulation. This is probably how the game actually won't, because the Steelers, they sling it. They just got real unlucky against the freaking Eagles, I guess. I don't know. Was it unlucky, or did they just get smacked around? Because it sounds like they just got smacked around, but maybe they're better than that. I'm banking on it, honestly. Not even banking on it, because I'm not putting any money down. But I feel like they're better than that.
Every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value.
Yo, these OBO 12 are going for so much money for no reason. They're going for like 800 to a G. Like legit. OBO 10s are only going for like 5, so it's a bit of a stretch, that 800. Takes the knee. That'll wrap it up, guys. M-Devil NFL Podcast. I don't know when this is going live, because I'm going to start uploading it right after it finishes rendering. But sometimes these podcasts take a really long time to upload for some reason to YouTube, because they struggle sometimes. But, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Next week, it'll be better, I promise. Hit that subscribe button for tons of Madden Ultimate Team pack openings. We got some packs coming on Sunday, which is tomorrow or today, depending on your time zone, all that good stuff. I'll see you guys next time. You guys already know what it is.